Good morning, Glenmore Elementary. This is Vanessa with your Jets Morning News Show. Today is Thursday, January 9th, 2023. It is our 89th day of school.
Today for lunch, we'll be having spaghetti or pizza.
Tomorrow for breakfast, we'll be having strawberry bagels.
Announcements. Tuesday, January the 24th is 80s Day. Let's have fun as we celebrate 80 rockin' days of school left in the school year. Join us in dressing up in your favorite 80s outfit.
Birthdays today. Genesis Garcia. Happy birthday!
The Spanish word of the day. The Spanish word for koala is koala. Say this new word with me three times.
Koala, koala, koala. Joke of the day. What is the number one game in the world? Uno.
Quote of the day. One of the most common causes of failure is habits of quitting when one of is overtaken by the temporary defeat.
Please stand for the pledges.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible. Today, I will do my best to be my best. What I do today will make a difference in my life. My choices will affect me and those around me. I will listen. I will be responsible. I will keep myself and others safe. I will be respectful to my class and teachers. I will learn something today because today matters and my future is built one now at a time.
One book, one school challenge. Here is the one book, one school challenge trivia question of the day.
Shoutouts to the following students for earning their orange belt in recorder karate. Mr. Nelson. Shoutouts to 5th grade for their creative project, robot projects, Miss Wright.
Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto, Domo. Domo. Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto, Domo. Domo. Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto, Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto.
Shout out to the top first grade runners and running club. Coach Farmer.
Way to go, Jets! Thankful Thursday. This is Ruby with Thankful Thursday. I am thankful that tomorrow will be Friday already. What are you thankful for this week?
Here is Miss McDonald with our video of the day. We hope you enjoy it as we continue to learn the importance of being respectful.
It's Thursday, Jets, and that means we're one day closer to the weekend. You've all done a great job of showing respect towards others, including your classmates and teachers this week. It's not easy when we have a short week, and there are many things that are crammed in your week, but you got it done. And you did it well. very respectfully, way to go. So now I want you to put your backpacks on the floor. If you have them near you, if you don't have them near you, I want you to put something on the floor that's meaningful for you, okay? Just lay them right there flat on the floor and don't do anything until I tell you to. I'll give you a little bit of time. Okay, if your backpack's on the floor or whatever it is that's on the floor next to you, and now I want you to stand up. And on the count of three, I want you to jump on it. Yes, I want you to jump on it, okay? All right, you ready? Don't go until I say go. Don't go until I count. Okay, ready? One, two. I'm just kidding. Don't jump on your backpacks or don't jump on your boxes. Don't jump on whatever it is that's down there on the floor. Did that get your attention this morning? I hope so. Okay, so now everybody sit back down and we'll finish our talk on respect. I never want you to do that to your backpack or any of your other personal items or school supplies that you have. We should always treat our personal items with respect. How do you treat your most valuable possession that you have? How do you treat it? You treat it with respect. I always treat my things with respect by putting them back where they belong and keeping up with them so they don't get lost. So did any of you buy the shoes that you're wearing today on your own? The shoes on your feet, did you buy them with your own money? Raise your hand if you did. If you did, I am very, very proud of you. It takes a long time to save up money because sometimes those shoes that you guys get now are very expensive. But many of you did not. We always say thank you, which is a sign of respect to the person who bought them for us, because can you imagine not having shoes on your feet? Can you imagine having to walk out on the playground in the wood chips or run for a running club without shoes on your feet? So you should always tell the person whoever buys you things, thank you. So we can consider how much our shoes cost. Let's say, for example, if you don't get really expensive shoes, and a pair of shoes costs about $40. That's about the average cost of what our shoes cost now. Now, say somebody works at a job. They make $10 an hour. How many hours would it take for them to have enough money to buy the shoes? Anybody, can anybody guess and tell your teacher? It would take 4 hours of work to buy one pair of shoes. So those shoes on your feet, they came at an expensive and high price. So should you drag them through the mud or not tie your laces? Should we draw on them with pencils or crayons or markers? No, we shouldn't. It's easy to disrespect the things we've given to us because we don't know or even forget how valuable they are. We often do this with people too. Treating people and things with respect shows that we realize the value they have and the honor that honors them. Everybody has honor, and we treat them with respect so that they know how valuable they are. This goes along with our story that we read yesterday. The read aloud went through the different ways to respect people, places, and things, and we are learning to be respectful students here at Glenmore every day. I hope you all have a really great Thursday, and I'll see you tomorrow.
With something to think about, this is Ruby,
Vanessa,
making a great day or not. The choice is yours.